Hey guys, it's Leo here. Welcome back to the Reading Project. Today we're going to read a book called The Girl with a Mind for Math, The Story of Raye Montague by Julia Finlay Mosca. If there's something you want but it seems out of reach, here's a story for you, a great truth it will teach. When you focus your mind, you'll succeed through and through, like one bold engineer by the name Montague. In a state we call Arkansas, one winter day, a baby was welcomed, a girl they called Raye. She was bright as a star, super smart from the start. She was headstrong, this child, and not faint of heart. Yes, this girl had potential. Her granddad was proud. He told her, "Work hard, you'll stand out from the crowd." Then something she cherished, when Raye was just 7, he took her to see her first ship. It was heaven. "A real submarine?" Her eyes opened wide. "Who made it?" she asked as they followed the guide. "Engineers," said the man, giving Ray's head a pat. "But my dear, you don't need to know all about that." At the time, the man's insult went over her head. "No, you can't," were the words he had meant but not said. Engineering, thought Raye, and her life's dream began, except most people laughed when she told them her plan. "Stay strong," said her mom. "Use your brains, you'll be fine. There will always be people who pay you no mind. Just because you're a girl and because you're black, don't let them or the state of your school hold you back." You see, schools in those days were what's called segregated. The black and white students were kept separated. "That's wrong," you exclaim. "It was dismal, no fooling. And worst of all, white kids received better schooling." But Raye studied hard. She had grit, taught herself. She was gifted in math and read books by the shelf. When the time came for college, she knew what to choose. She'd learned to build boats, but she got some bad news. "Engineering's not taught to black students," they said. Her heart hit the floor. "I'll take business instead." She'd learn what she could, and she'd learn the rest later. The rules were unjust, but that school wouldn't break her. Raye finished with honors. "Oh boy, what a smarty," she said her farewells. There was no time to party. "I'm off to a place filled with history's greets, the capital city of all 50 states." Now finding a job, it turned out that took time. She looked and she looked. Raye was not one to whine. Then it must have been faith, at least that's what it seems. She was hired to type where they built submarines. The Navy, that's right. Oh, but hold all your cheers. Ship designing was only for trained engineers. So she watched as they worked and she learned every task, even studied computers by night in the class. Then her big break arrived. The whole staff got the flu. Raye did all of her work and the engineers too. Her boss was in shock. "How?" he exploded. "From memory," said Raye, and with that, got promoted. Life should have been swell, yet that wasn't the case. Her boss treated her poorly because of her race. Many people like him tried to make her feel small. Raye just held her head high, and she outworked them all. What next? From the White House, there came a command. The president ordered a ship, make it grand, and quickly, he added. Well, that didn't fly. All those plans would take engineers months to supply. Here's the thing about that. When designing a boat, there are thousands of measurements one needs to note. All those numbers take math, and that takes some time. But Raye had been working on something sublime. She took a deep breath. "I can solve this," she said. "I've come up with a system to do it instead. I'll draw the plans faster," she told him. "Don't fret. I'll design the first ship by computer. No sweat." "How long do you think that might take?" "What's your guess? Would it take her a month? Maybe weeks for success?" Well, it took calculations and tons of caffeine, but Raye finished in hours just over 18. Her program? It worked. All the blueprints were done. The ship was constructed, the engineers stunned. "You did it," they cheered, and her boss had to say that her quick mind for math had in fact saved the day. The end? No, not quite. When Raye's ship was unveiled, only white men could go, and Raye's invite? Not mailed. Say what? You heard right. No invite? abhorrible. In fact, some might say it was downright deplorable. Yet Raye kept her cool, gave her best every day, and in time all her skills were applauded. Hooray! People learned of her work. Who's this, Raye? They demand. When they met her, they stared. They expected a man. Yes, that happened a lot. Many could not believe that a woman of color did all she'd achieved. Some even thought Raye was a maid. Sad but true. When they ordered a drink, she'd say, "Bring me one too." All her humor and wit served her well through the years, as she battled the hard times with laughs and not tears. And that boss in the Navy who'd been so unkind made Raye the first woman to lead ship design. More honors would follow, her fame picked up steam, and finally at last she accomplished her dream. That title she'd worked for, an engineer, score! Now that the world knows her feats, she is hidden no more. Raye Montague, engineer. So the lesson to all is don't ever give in. Take a chance, rock the boat, if it sinks, you can swim. When a storm comes your way, hold your course and don't stress. Never quit, and like Raye, propel straight to success. Dear reader, if you have a dream like I did, study hard and stay focused. Always remember that just because someone says you can't, that doesn't have to stop you. You might have to go in a different direction and it might take you a little longer, but you can achieve your dreams. Raye Montague. The end. Thanks for watching. I love that story, and I really hope so did you guys. If you liked this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe, turn on the bell notification, and please share. To see you next time.